The world of online poker is like a giant casino that never closes, with hundreds of millions of players joining games day or night. Unlike a real poker game, online players can't see who it is they're up against. They might be amateurs, they might be seasoned pros, and some might be computer programs.
All the poker chat rooms are full of people accusing other players of being bots, but no one really knows who's behind them.
Online poker is f***ed right now.
This is definitely like a non-human.
The trust is gone. You can't go and play high-stakes online poker anymore and assume that you're playing a fair game.
A poker bot is a computer program that plays the game at the highest level. There's evidence they've been used on major poker sites for a number of years.
This is a kind of dirty secret of online poker.
While some who use them do get caught, it's unclear just how many are getting away with it.
It's kind of off-putting for amateurs. And without the new flow of players coming into the business, the whole poker economy could fall to pieces. I wanted to find out where poker bots come from, who makes them, and why. I had no idea what to expect.
In the early 2000s, online poker exploded. A critical moment was in 2003, where an accountant from Tennessee called Chris Moneymaker, yes, that's his real name, got to the finals of the World Series of Poker. Unlike his main competitors, his journey started at a qualifying event online. It finished in Vegas with a $2.5 million prize pot. His victory inspired millions around the world to try their luck, just as online poker sites began to proliferate. Throughout this era, players could be confident that their opponents were in fact just people. But it wasn't long until machines started creeping into the online game. The most efficient bots are fully automated. Their software runs in the background on a player's computer, making bets, folding, raising, all without any human input. If it's sophisticated, it can write in a chat box or move the mouse to appear to be less machine and more human. Another way they run is to have an actual person take prompts from the software, which makes it a lot harder for poker sites to detect.
The simplest and most effective way to spot a bot is to see if there are other poker accounts playing in exactly the same way. No two human beings will play the exact same style of poker in a given situation. But if there are two accounts making the same decisions over hundreds and hundreds of hands, then you can be fairly certain that they're bots. The other issue is that almost any detection tool you could use as a poker website to keep bots off your platform, there's a workaround. If a decision is being made in a hand of poker after 2.3 seconds in every single hand, you might assume there's a computer doing that. But then, of course, once that security measure comes in, the bot farms will program their software to randomize the decision-making time. So it might take 1 second, it might take 10 seconds.
Bots have become so smart, some even know when they need to be a little less smart.
The best poker bots need to be able to operate on a platform without being detected, and that means losing every now and again. Bots will deliberately throw hands, bots will deliberately make occasional bad decisions just to try and fool the people running the website into thinking that they're people.
Policing bots becomes even harder due to the very nature of the game itself. It is vast and complicated, with multiple ways to win in multiple situations.
Well, there's no such thing as perfect poker. It, as a concept, it can't exist. Because poker has a random element and is a subjective decision-making process. Poker is a very cerebral, challenging game. It's not just about the information that you have, it's about the information you don't have.
Take the no-limit version of the most popular poker game, Texas Hold'em. Not only can you bet any amount, you can bet any object, making the possible outcomes theoretically greater than the number of atoms in the universe. Pause the video if you need a minute to think about this. So there's a reason a computer beat Garry Kasparov at chess decades before a machine could compete on a poker table. Deep Blue's 11 billion calculations per second could analyze the best movement on a chessboard, but it couldn't help it behave like a human. Essential in poker.
It requires a combination of sort of mathematical processing abilities to weigh risk and probability, but it also requires the ability to read other human beings and their behavior. the ability to lie convincingly, to bluff.
That's why poker has become so critical for scientists developing neural networks and artificial intelligence. By 2017, researchers at Carnegie Mellon University had finally started to compete with humans, with its software beating a top poker player.
While the academics were researching poker for the purposes of AI, there were commercially minded poker professionals doing the same thing for the purposes of making money in poker markets. When I first started looking at poker bots, I would scroll through these poker forums. There was consistent references to this one operation that everyone called BF Corp, BotFarm Corporation. Someone who said he was a whistleblower described the scale of the operation, the numerous offices that it had, how they managed to remain undetected. I'd spoken to dozens of people who had worked with this group from Siberia. I suppose it was inevitable the word would get back to them. And sure enough, one day out of the blue, they messaged me saying, yeah, we're the neo-pokerists and we hear you want to talk to us. I had no idea what to expect. I've never met a poker botter before. A lot of the online stuff about them made them seem quite menacing. And when I first met them, they showed up in these two SUVs with black tinted windows. But when I sat down with them, you know, they were quite friendly and charming. BotFarm Corporation started life as a bunch of student kids in a university in Siberia. And they found quite quickly that if they stayed up all night playing poker against Americans on the other side of the world, they could make a bit of money. And eventually, because they were all computer game enthusiasts, they made the decision to see if they could replicate the quality of poker they were playing as people in a piece of software that could play all night, didn't need sleep, didn't need to eat. I was maybe expecting them to deny that their main source of income was using poker software to play against humans, but they didn't really. They said they were the people behind all the different incarnations of the group, from BF Corporation to Neolab through to Dplay. We found evidence on the Russian business registry of maybe half a dozen separate legal entities that made up the BotFarm operation. For their main business, Dplay. You can see dozens of job listings advertising a role in this company that's essentially a gambling entity.
The confirmation of BotFarm Corporation's existence has sent shockwaves through the online poker community, revealing a far bigger problem than many could believe.
If they were discovered and their accounts were shut down, it was a simple matter for them to start again with a new clean account. And they adapted this business model over the years so that eventually they were renting out their software to people who ran their own bot farms, kind of like a franchisee system.
The Russian bot makers say they deployed their software on major poker platforms since 2012. It's unclear if there are any other outfits like them. So while it's obvious why players wouldn't want to compete against bots, the question seems to be why the platforms aren't doing more to combat them.
It's definitely in the financial interests of the poker industry to always have tables busy, always have bets being made. And the reality is that poker bots is a simple way to do that. What that means is when someone logs on to their computer, there have to be active games. No one wants to see a bunch of empty tables. So tables have to be constantly churning over, games constantly happening. That's really difficult to do with human beings because most human beings tend to log on at the same time. I was astonished to learn that some poker websites have internal in-house poker bots that they use to keep tables busy. This is a kind of dirty secret of online poker.
While the major platforms haven't been implicated in running their own bots, player confidence is a major issue. Conservative estimates put the number of online poker players at over 100 million people globally, with billions of dollars flowing across digital tables. Without reining in the bots, those numbers are more than likely to decline.
The issue is there's no poker regulator to make sure that bots are kept off the platforms. I think what we're already seeing is poker becoming a lot less fun. When you are playing online and you feel like you might be playing against a machine with no feelings that you have no chance of beating, that's not fun. And when poker stops being fun, people will eventually stop playing it.